गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो स्टूडेंट, लेट स्टार्ट द चैप्टर नंबर 2, प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. टुडे वी विल बी जस्ट रिवाइजिंग दिस चैप्टर नंबर 2, विच इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ योर टर्म फर्स्ट सिलेबस. नाउ चैप्टर नंबर 2 इज़ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. वी ऑलरेडी हैड अबाउट मैनेजमेंट, दैट वॉट इज़ मैनेजमेंट. नाउ वॉट आर द डिफरेंट प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट विच वी बेसिकली फॉलोड इन आर बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Now students, what are management principle first? See, the principle of management are general guidelines and managerial decision making. It means, what are principle of management? Principle of management are all those general guidelines which help a manager to take the decision and to change the behavior of human being, right? So what are principle of management? It is all those general guidelines which help manager to take decision making and also to change the behavior of human being. Now next is the nature of principle of management. What type of nature or characteristics a principle of management contain? So student, principle of management has a universal applicability nature. Universal applicability nature say that it is used everywhere, right? It may be used in the organization which are small or in the organization which are big. It can be used even any type of organization, whether they are public, private, profit organization, non-profit organization. So that is the reason, because its applicability are used each and every way, that is the reason we call it have a characteristics or nature of universal applicability. Now next is, they are formed by practice and experimentation. So student, the principle of management are formed after going through with a deep practice of a manager and from the different experimentation which a manager did, right? Next features or nature said that they are flexible and can be modified by manager when the situation show demand. So this nature say flexibility. Flexibility nature basically say that the principle of management are flexible. They are not just a rule of thumb, right, which has been made so everybody has to follow. They are flexible in nature. According to the demand or situation in the organization, manager can modify or change them. Now the next nature of principle of management is influencing human behavior. Now it basically say that they are aimed at influencing human behavior so that they are mainly behavior in nature. This principle said that the principle of management are basically formed after going through with a long experience of manager. Now this principle of management allowed lots of guidelines by which the manager can to influence or to change the behavior of employee. Now the next feature said, or the next nature of principle of management say, that contingency or dependency. This basically say that the principle of management are dependent on the situation which has prevailed earlier at a particular point of time. It basically say it's related that if a particular principle of management has been used in a particular situation, it might be possible when the situations are different that principle will be not used. So it's completely dependent on the situations. So these all are the nature of principle of management. Now what are the significance of principle of management? Significance of principle of management basically say that if a organizer or a manager is going through with the principle of management, what type of significance it give to the organization. Now first is useful insight into reality. Principle of management are the general guidelines which help manager to go through with the reality and take decision according to that. Next is optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. Now because principle of management are made after going through with a long practice and experimentation, right? So just because of this, there is a proper use of resources. The manager does not allow to waste the resources, and when there is an optimum utilization of resources, effective administrations or productivity is done. Next is they help to take scientific decision, because principle of management are related with the experimentation also. So whenever there is any scientific decision has to take, the principle of management help a manager. Next significance say that meeting changing environment requirement. As I have already informed you that they are not rule of thumb. They can be changed according to the situation of a organization. That's why it's saying that it help us to meet changing environment requirement also. Time to time, it guide us that how we have to change our principle according to the requirement of the organization. And the principle of management also fulfill the social responsibility because they are made after going through with a long observation of economic also, business also, or even a society also. So after that only these principles are prepared, so it fulfill the society responsibility also, because a business organization is running between the society only. Next said that they are used databases for management training, education and research. Principle of management also allowed or help at the time of providing training, education and providing research for a particular topic, because they go through with the observation policies where they collect the data, and on the basis of this data they use the data for providing training or education to the employee of the organization. So these all are about the importance of principle of management. Children, because we are revising this chapter, so I will be not going very deeply in that. Now next is principle of management. Now children, when we talk about the principle of management, we basically talking about the classical theory, right? The classical theory, according to the classical theory, there are three people who has started there and who has participated in the classical theories. But according to our syllabus, we will be only going through with Henry Fayol administrative theory and Frederick Winslow Taylor scientific theory, right? So first I would just like to give you a little bit introduction about Henry Fayol administrative theory. So HF administrative theory is related with classical theory. Now when we talk about Henry Fayol administrative theory, this theory was belong to administrative theories. Administrative theory basically means they have given more importance to the administrative part. When we talk about F.W. Taylor, that is Frederick Winslow Taylor, they have a scientific management theory because he is a scientist there. So he has given a scientific management theory, but both the theory are from classical theories, right? So let's see what type of theory HF has been given, Henry Fayol has given. So according to the Fayol principle of management, he has given 14 principles, right? So these principles are division of work. The division of work of work principle of Henry Fayol said that work should be divided into small tasks, job, each performed by specialist or trained employee. Fayol principle has, or Henry Fayol has given 14 principle in the management. His first principle was division of work. In this principle he said that the work into the organization has to be divided into small part or task, and each job has to be given to that person who is trained or specialist in that particular work, so that productivity can be increased. This is the first principle which is given by Henry Fayol. Total 14 principle has been mentioned by Henry Fayol, and his second principle is authority and responsibility. Children, this function or this principle of Fayol are related with two word, authority and responsibility. So let clear what is authority. Student, authority basically means right to give orders and obtain obediency. Means when we have a power to give order to somebody, and when we obtain obediency of somebody, means somebody has to follow us. So that is our authority, that is our power. Responsibility means obligation to perform a job assigned to on time. It means when we have been given certain work and it's our obligation to perform that work, it means we are responsible for that work, right? So you can say authority related to power and responsibility related to certain work. Fayol has suggested that there must be a balance between authority and responsibility. This principle of Fayol said that whenever any authority has been given to any employee, with that authority there should be a responsibility should also come. It means there should be a balancing between authority and responsibility. we should not give over authority to somebody and we should not give over burden or over responsibility to someone. So we should make a balancing between authority and responsibility, means power and work. Discipline. This is the third principle of FEOL. It say that it means obedience to organizational rules and employment agreement. Means all the employee of the organization should obey the rules and regulation of the organization and plus whatever are mentioned in the employment agreement. So if this is there, it means discipline is there, or any organization which have discipline will definitely get the success. Fourth principle was unity of command. This say that an employee should receive order, instruction from one and only one boss or superior. It basically means that one person or one employee who is working into the organization should have only one boss who is giving command to him. It should not be there that a same person is getting instruction or command from lots of people, because what will happen anyhow, that case the person can get confused. Next principle said centralization and decentralization. Now centralization and decentralization are two words just opposite to each other. Student, centralization basically say concentration of decision making authority by top management. It means when top management keep all the power of taking decision with himself only, we call it centralized organization. Where any business where the top management also give the decision making power to all the level of the organization, we call it decentralization. So according to this principle of FEOL, he said there should be a balancing between centralization and decentralization. Means the organization or the manager has to be very clear how much decision making power or which decision power has to be given to the other level and which has to be keep or concentration to kept by top only. Next principle said unity of direction. Unity of direction basically said that all the unit of the organization or all the employee of the organization or department of the organization should be moving toward the same objective. And this objective is what? This objective is organizational objective. It should not be there that everybody or all the employee in the organization are running toward their own objective, right? Next principle said subordination of individual interest to general interest. It means the interest of the organization should supersede the interest of any individual employee. Means into the organization, each and every employee should give more importance to the objective of organization. They should not take first priority to their own objective. Next is scalar chain. Now this principle say that there should be a proper line of authority from highest to lowest rank. That is what it's called scalar chain. It basically suggests that the communication from top to bottom should follow the official line of command. Student, in scalar chain, this principle of FEOL said that there should be a proper defined scale chain which can allow that who is supposed to communicate whom. And this chain should be made in such a way that communication from top to bottom should be followed. Like, just opposite of this is what? Just opposite of scalar chain is gangplank. It's just a shorter route and has been provided so that communication has not been delayed. Now, he basically said that there should be a scalar chain system for the communication purpose should be followed into the organization, where the communication should follow from top to bottom. But in case there are short route required for that purpose, gangplank can be used. Next is remuneration of employee. Remuneration of employee principle said that should be just equitable to provide maximum satisfaction to employee as well as employer. It means at the time of deciding remuneration, both should be satisfied, the employee also and the employer also. Means employee should also get that much of amount by which he can live properly, and employee should also understand the issues of employer, that how much amount is convenient for him to pay to the employee. So both should be satisfied, employee also and the employer also. Order principle of FEOL said that there should be a fixed place for every person, everything into the organization, and each and everything should be present on that particular place whenever it is required. Next principle was initiative. Initiative principle of Fuel said that employee should be encouraged to make execute plan within the prescribed limit of authority. So initiative principle is basically giving importance to the employees also. So in this way, they can come forward, they can give their own suggestion and ideas also, and in that way, within a particular authority, within a particular power only, we can allow the employees also, we can encourage the employee also to come forward and suggest their plan and suggest their creativity. Next is stability of personnel. Stability of personnel of Fuel said that employees should not be moved from their position frequently. It means once appointment has been done, then we should give a proper chance or proper time to the employee to show their talent or to show the result. We should not turn or move out the employee very frequently. Next is equity. Equity principle said that we should have, or the manager should have, the equal feeling or equal behavior toward his worker. He or she should not have any type of discrimination on the basis of sex, caste, language, color or region. Next is spread decrops. This Fuel principle say that there is a need of teamwork. There is a need of spirit of unity and harmony among the employee. And for this, what a manager should do? A manager should replace I with we. Now these all are the 14 principle of Henry Fuel. Now next we will be going through with the second principle of theory, classical theory of management, which was given by F.W. Taylor, who is called as a scientific management also. Now according to him, he has given four principle, and the first principle was science not rule of thumb. According to F.W. Taylor, Taylor believed that there was only one best method to maximize efficiency, which can be developed through scientific study. This principle say that Taylor believed that there can be lots of methods for doing any work, but there is always one best method for doing that work. And it is the responsibility of a manager to, by the way of observation, experience and his own talent, to search out that best method and make that best method compulsory or mandatory for all the organization to follow. Next principle is harmony, not discord. There should be complete harmony between the management and the worker, because if there will be not harmony between the management and the worker, they will not work as a team, then the objective of the organization will never be achieved. Now next principle is cooperation, not individualism. This principle say that every employee should work into the organization with full cooperation, not for individual interest. Means there should be a proper cooperation between employee and to the organization. Employee should give his full potential so that the objective of the organization can be achieved. Next principle said development of each and every person to his or her greatest efficiency. This principle of Taylor is saying that each person should be scientifically selected. They should be given required training to learn best method. According to this principle of Taylor, they said that whenever there is appointment of any employee into the organization, they should be selected on the basis of scientifically procedure. And once the selection has been done, they should be, or employee should be, given complete chances of training so that development can be occurred. These are the four principles of Taylor, which was given by him. Now next are the Taylor technique of scientific management. What technique Taylor has used to provide scientific management? So according to Taylor, his first technique of scientific management was functional foremanship. Now functional foremanship basically say, he said, Taylor said that the factory work should be observed by 8 type of specialist foremen. What Taylor basically has done in the functional foremanship is that he has divided the work into two ways, that
a work which is related with the planning, it should have a different department, it should be done from a different people, and the work which are related with the production, it should be done by different people and different department. So functional foremanship technique of Taylor has divided the whole factory workers into two groups, that was planning department and the production department. In the planning department, again it was instruction card clerk, route color clerk, time and cost clerk, and discipline officer. In the production department, it was gang boss, speed boss, repair boss, and inspector. And at the down, it was worker. So what is happening here? A factory worker is basically observed by 8 type of specialist foremen, and they are getting instruction from all these 8 people. So this is about functional foremanship. Now the next technique of scientific management of Taylor said standardization and simplification of work. According to this technique of Taylor, he said that standardization basically means that we should set a particular standard or a benchmark for each and every activity of a business. Like benchmark should be decided for the raw material, that what type, kind of, what quality of raw material we will be using into the organization, how much time we will take, what will be the procedure, what type of product will be produced, what type of machines will be used, which method will be used, what will be the working condition provided to the employee. So a particular benchmark will be decided, and these standards and the benchmark will be followed during the time of production by everybody. Next is simplification. This technique basically say it refer to eliminating or removing unnecessary diversity of product to make production process into simple and reducing labor cost. So this technique of Taylor said that we should make the production work more simple, and this is possible only if we will remove the unnecessary diversification of product, means we'll make a similar nature of product. Next principle said, or next technique of Taylor, is method study. Method study basically said that it is the main objective of a manager to find the best method for doing the job. Next is fatigue study. It basically determines the amount and frequency of rest interval in completing a task. It means when an employee is working or performing a job, to determine that how much amount or how much frequency of rest interval he is taking to perform that work or to complete that work, that is done by the help of fatigue study. Time study, it basically determines the standard time to perform a particular work. मीन्स एक काम को करने में हमें कितना टाइम लग रहा है, उस स्टैंडर्ड टाइम को मेज़र करने के लिए टाइम स्टडी यूज़ होता है. मोशन स्टडी बेसिकली इट अलाउ अस टू स्टडी द मूवमेंट लाइक लिफ्टिंग, पुटिंग ऑब्जेक्ट, सिटिंग, चेंजिंग पोजिशन विच आर अंडरटेकन वाइल डूइंग द जॉब, एंड वॉट इज़ द पर्पज़ टू गो थ्रू विद द मोशन स्टडी. इट्स बेसिकली टू रिड्यूस द और टू एलिमिनेट द अननेसेसरी मूवमेंट by which the employee is wasting the time also, and productivity is also getting decreased. Next technique was differential piece weight system. This technique basically say it differentiate between efficient and less efficient worker. According to Taylor, he said that we should differentiate between the worker who are efficient for work and those who are not efficient for work. And the salary or the wages should be provided good or more to the people, those who are efficient, and less to the people, those who are not performing their work better. So these all are the technique which was given by Taylor. So with this, we have finished with the revision of chapter number 2, that was principle of management.